الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد الحمد لله we gather to remind ourselves with a verse from the book of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. That is in Surah Al-Fusilat, verse 30 to 32, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا تَتَنَزُّلُ عَلَيْهِمْ الْمَلَائِكَةُ أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوَعَدُونَ نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاؤُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِي أَنفُسُكُمْ وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَدَّعُونَ نُزُلًا مِنْ غَفُورٍ رَحِيمٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in these verses, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهِ. Though, indeed, those who say, my Lord is Allah. They are upon tawheed, ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. Then they follow that up with istiqama, by being upright. تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ. Angels descend upon them, saying to them, أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا. Do not fear, do not feel any distress. وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوَعَدُونَ. And glad tidings for you will be paradise, that which you were promised. نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاؤُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. We are your awliya. We are your guardians in this life. We were your guardians in this life and in the hereafter. Or we are your guardians in this life at the point of death. And in the hereafter, we will be your guardians. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed over you as protection. نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاؤُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِي أَنفُسُكُمْ. And you will have that which your soul desires of good. يعني in the آخِرَةِ وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَدَّعُونَ. And you will have that which you were promised and that which you seek. نُزُلًا مِنْ غَفُورٍ رَحِيمٍ. That which has been revealed or have been sent down by Al-Ghafoor Al-Rahim to you as a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For he is Al-Ghafoor, no doubt, he is the all-forgiving and the merciful. This great verse, Na'am, Shaykh Abdul Rahman Al-Sa'di, rahimahullah, the great scholar of tafsir, he mentioned, he said, يُخْبِرُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْ أَوْلِيَائِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned about those who are from his awliya, those who uphold the obligatory duties, the obligatory actions, the fara'id. And they follow that up with the nawafil, with the voluntary acts. And that is described in the hadith Qudsi, which is in Bukhari. And Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu qala, qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, qala Allah ta'ala, man aada li waliyan faqad adhantu bil harb. Whoever harms a guardian or a wali of mine, then I am at war with him. Whoever harms a wali of mine, then I am at war with him. And who are the awliya? Is mentioned this hadith. وَمَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءٍ أَحَبَّ إِلَيْهِ مَا افْتَرَضْتُ عَلَيْهِ. There isn't anything that my servant comes close to me with that which I have obligated upon him. وَلَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلِ. And my servant continues to come closer to me with the nawafil, the voluntary acts. Hatta uhibba, until I love him. فَإِذَا أَحْبَبْتَهُ كُنْتُ سَمْعَهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَعُ بِهِ. So when I love him, that I become his hearing which he hears with. وَبَصَرًا الَّذِي يُبْصِرُ بِهِ. And he's seeing with that which he sees with. He only sees good things. He only hears good things. وَيَدَهُ الَّتِي يُطِشُ بِهَا وَرِجِلَهُ الَّتِي يَمْشِ بِهَا. And I become his يعني hands in that which he grasps with. And his feet that which he goes, he walks with, yani towards, meaning he only grasps that which is good, he only deals with that which is good with his hands, and likewise with his feet, he only goes to those places which are good. وَإِذَا سَأَلَنِي لَأُعْطِيَنَّ. And when he asks of me, that I give him. When he asks of me, then I give him. وَإِذَا اسْتَعَادَنِي لَأُعِيدَنَّ. And when he seeks protection of me, then I forgive him, of a surety I forgive him. When he seeks protection of me, I grant it to him. Not forgive him, but I grant it to him, the protection, isti'ada. And when he asks for my protection, then I give it to him, his protection. And they are the awliya of Allah. The awliya of Allah
Allah said, "Ala inna awliya Allah la khawfun alayhim wa lahum yahzanun." Indeed, the awliya of Allah, there's no fear for them, nor any distress or grief. And in the other verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the awliya of Allah, who they are, those who've been given this great status, the great status of being comforted with paradise at the point of death. Who are the awliya of Allah? Inna awliya Allah, in one verse he mentioned, "Ala la khawfun alayhim wa lahum yahzanun." And in the next verse he said, "Alladhina amanu wa kanu yattaqun." Those who believe and they used to fear him. They used to believe correctly. They are the awliya of Allah. "Alladhina amanu wa kanu yattaqun." And they are upon taqwa. And taqwa is that you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon a light from Allah, seeking His pleasure. And you keep away from the prohibited matters upon a light from Allah, meaning guidance from Allah, fearing His punishments. As the one of the great scholars of the Salaf, the Talq ibn Habib, had mentioned. So, the awliya of Allah, they're the ones at the point of death who will be given this glad tidings. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends the angels to them not to fear, not to distress, to have distress. تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَعْزَنُوا. And this is for the people of Tawheed. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهِ. They are upon Tawheed, they are upon Ikhlas. They are upon the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely. They don't call upon others besides Allah. They don't rely upon others besides Allah. They bring about the actions of the heart of Iman, and the actions of the limbs of Iman, and the actions of the tongue of Iman, the speech of the tongue of Iman. And that is, their tongues are moist with the dhikr of Allah. لَا يَزَالُ لِسَانُكَ رَطْبًا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Because they are upon Tawheed, and they love to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they are upon the dhikr of Allah. And the best of the dhikr of Allah is recitation of the Qur'an. They are upon the recitation of the Qur'an on a daily basis. They read the Qur'an. Because they know the Qur'an will aid them in this life. Will aid them. Because it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The recitation, the pondering, and the acting in accordance with the Qur'an. They are upon that. They love the Qur'an. Because they know that this Qur'an guides to that which is upright. إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمَ. They want to be upon istiqama. They want to be upon uprightness. And so they read the Qur'an and they ponder over it. And it increases, increases them in the iman. For indeed, not only increases them in iman, it makes the heart softened. It makes the heart content. أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ. Indeed, in the remembrance of Allah, the hearts are content. So they read the Qur'an. And they ponder over the Qur'an because they know tafakkur bil-Qur'an, pondering over the Qur'an, or tadabbur bil-Qur'an, is ibadah. أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنِ وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. If it had been from other than Allah, then they would have found many contradictions in it. أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنِ أَمْ عَلَى قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا. Don't they ponder over the Qur'an, or is it that they have a seal in their hearts? So they love the Qur'an, and they are upon the Qur'an. And the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم was described by Aisha رضي الله عنها. She said, كَانَ خُلُقُهُ الْقُرْآنِ. That his etiquette and his manner was in accordance with the Qur'an. That is our guide, the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. And he guided us to that. And likewise, we emulate the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, follow his guidance by reading the Qur'an and pondering over it. And pondering over it is knowing, is understanding. As Shaykh Abdul Rahman al-Sa'd rahmullah mentioned in those verses, when he explained those verses, is to follow the understanding of the Qur'an. That's upon istiqamah. That's the person upon istiqamah. He follows the understanding of the Qur'an, the correct understanding of the Qur'an, the correct meaning of the Qur'an. It's not about just paraphrasing the words. Just the person just reads without understanding. The person memorized without understanding. Abdul Rahman ibn Muljam from the Khawarij, who killed Ali radiallahu anhu, he partook in the killing of Ali radiallahu anhu, the fourth caliph. Abdul Rahman ibn Muljam partook in the killing of him, yet he memorized the Quran. So it wasn't about memory or memorization. It was about pondering over it, benefiting from it, and following it. Memorizing, alhamdulillah, is khair, is good. But memorizing and then opposing that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls you to, this is dangerous. And the Qur'an becomes a proof against you. As in a hadith, the authentic hadith, which is Sunan Ibn Majah, وَالْقُرْآنُ حُجَّةٌ لَكَ أَوْ عَلَيْكَ, and the Quran is a proof for you or against you. So, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهِ, they say Allah is my Lord. They're the people of istiqamah. They're the people of tawheed and sunnah. But they don't just do it one day or one off. ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُ also necessitates continuity. As Allah said about the salah, those people who establish the salah, الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَىٰ صَلَاتِهِمْ دَائِمُونَ, those upon their prayer, they are continuous, continuity. So they are upon istiqamah. Shaykh Abdul Rahman al-Sa'di rahimahullah said, أَيْ اِعْتَرَفُوا وَنَطَقُوا وَرَضُوا بِرُبُوبِيَةِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَىٰ. They اِعْتَرَفُوا, they recognize and they accept and they establish with their speech and they are pleased with the rububiyyah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاسْتَسْلَمُوا لِأَمْرِهِ, and they submit to his command. Just as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَدْخُلُوا فِي سِلْمِ كَافَّةِ, and enter into Islam wholeheartedly. Don't pick and choose. فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ فِي مَا شَجْرَ بَيْنَهُمْ ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرْجًا مِمَّا قَضَيْتَ وَيُسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. By Allah, of a surety they do not believe until they make you, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a judge in all of their affairs. And then they find in their hearts no hesitance in accepting that. And they submit to it wholeheartedly. These are the people of sunnah. These are the people of istiqamah. And they submit to it wholeheartedly. Without any hesitance in their hearts. Without any shakiness in their hearts. Without any doubt in their hearts. They have yaqeen. ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. They are upon that. فقال الشيخ عبد الرحمن السعدي رحمه الله ثم استقاموا على الصراط المستقيم استقاموا على الصراط المستقيم ما استقاموا على الدنيا والهوى وزينتها استقاموا على الصراط المستقيم. They were upright upon the صراط المستقيم, and Allah said وأن هذا صراط مستقيم فاتبعوه, and this is my straight path, so follow it. وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِ مُسْتَقِيمَ فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ, and do not follow other paths, they will lead you away from his path. ذَلِكُمْ وَصَّاكُمْ بِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, that is what he has advised you with, that you may be upon piety, istiqama, mustaqim. Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah said, المستقيم هو الصراط الذي لا إعوجاج فيه, that صراط where there is no crookedness in it. It is straight. It is the shortest path. People think that they try to find shortcuts or they try to find other paths. By Allah, they will never be able to find any other path that leads to this salvation. Of قال الله قال رسول الله قال الصحابة, that the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called to, the Sahaba called to, and Allah sent down. They will never be able to find any other way but this path. This is the Sirat al-Mustaqim. The Sirat al-Ladina an'amta alayhim. The path of Allah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an'amta alayhim, had blessed those who were blessed with it. And they are the ones Allah mentioned the other verse. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَأُولَئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَصِدِّقِينَ وَشُهَدَاءُ الصَّالِحِينَ وَحَسُنَ أُولَئِكَ رَفِيقًا. They are the ones who obey Allah and obey the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. They are the ones who be with thee. The ones that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed. مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ, from the prophets. وَصِدِّقِينَ, the truthful ones. وَشُهَدَاءُ الصَّالِحِينَ, and the martyrs. And the صالحين, and the righteous. You'll be with them inshallah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are raised with them, the best of the people. They are the best companionship that you can ever have. وَحَسُنَ أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا, to be the companions of the Nabiyeen. Ya Abdullah, what is better than that? What is better than to be with the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Akhirah, and to be with the Anbiya and the Mursaleen, and to be with the Sahaba, rather, and the best people of this Ummah? What is better than that? What is better than that for a few days of patience? For a few days of istiqama? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless the people of istiqama with these blessings. And before even that, at the point of death, تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ, the angels will come upon them. The soul of the believer trickles out of his body like the water trickling like the trickle of water that comes down. And with ease, subhanAllah, with ease. Yes, there are agonies of death. Prior to one's soul leaving him, yes, there are agonies. The Messenger ﷺ himself would sweat. And he would say, إِنَّ لِلْمَوْتِ لَسَكَرَاتِ. Indeed, death has agonies. And he would sweat, and he find it, at the point of death, it was difficult, no doubt. But as the soul leaves the believer, it leaves like the trickle of water. And for the disbelievers, it would be like skewers coming out of the cotton wool. Yani of wool. Very difficult, because the disbeliever's soul doesn't want to come out of his body. The disbeliever's soul wants to remain in the dunya. If they had a chance or had a will, or the decision, they would love to be here forever in this dunya. But that decision is not theirs. The decision belongs to Allah. كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ. Every soul will taste death. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَوْ كُنْتُمْ فِي بُرُوجٍ مُشَيَّدَةٍ. يعني, even if you are in tall, beautified towers, you're within those towers and you're trying to hide, يُدْرِكُمُ الْمَوْتِ, death will reach you. Death will find you. Death will come to you. It's coming to each and every one of us. And it is not you making that appointment. It's already been appointed. وَجَاءَتْ سَكْرَةُ الْمَوْتِ بِالْحَقِّ وَجَاءَتْ سَكْرَةُ الْمَوْتِ بِالْحَقِّ. It will come to you. ذَلِكَ مَا كُنْتَ مِنْهُ تَحِيدُ. That is what you were running away from. That is what you were trying to keep away from. That is what you didn't expect. That is going to be a long life. No, life is short. ذَلِكَ مَا كُنْتَ مِنْهُ تَحِيدُ. وَجَاءَتْ كُلُّ نَفْسِ مَعَهَا سَائِقٌ وَشَهِيدٌ. And every soul will come with those angels that are bringing them forward. Sa'iqum wa shaheed. Those who bore witness to what you were doing. Those angels that used to write everything that you used to do. Kiraman katibin ya'lamuna ma taf'alun. Angels that are honorable writing everything that you used to do. Recorded in your book. Wa ma adraka ma illiyun. Kitabun marqum. Yashhaduhu al-muqarrabun. For the righteous it will be illiyun. They will be receiving their record, righteous. And so they will receive that. And it's for the muqarrabun, for the righteous, for those who are close, in the highest of places. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا سِجِّين. How about those who will get their book of record, a sijjin, that which will be for them. كِتَابٌ مَرْقُومٌ. Already it is also recorded. وَيْلٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلْمُكَذِّبِينَ الَّذِينَ يُكَذِّبُونَ بِيَوْمِ الدِّينِ. So woe to those repudiators, those who deny the Day of Judgment. الَّذِينَ يُكَذِّبُونَ بِيَوْمِ الدِّينِ وَمَا يُكَذِّبُ بِهِ إِلَّا كُلُّ مُعْتَدٍ أَثِيمٍ. And the one, and none denies it except كُلُّ مُعْتَدٍ أَثِيمٍ, the one who is sinful, one who rejects and is sinful. The sinful ones, they sin until their hearts become blackened with sins, darkened with sins, and they can't recognize the truth anymore. بَرَّانَ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ مَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. Their sins had overcome them, all that they used to do. It's been written, and it overcomes them, engulfs their heart, darkened with sins. بَرَّانَ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ مَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. What their own hands have put forward. Whatever calamity befalls you, own hands, it's because of your own hands or our own hands. So we reflect in these times of difficulty and calamity, and we know whatever happened of calamity is because of our own hands. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests the people to be upon istiqamah or not, to see if they turn away or not, to see if they are upon longevity, upon continuity, or are they just upon this deen, or upon this da'wah, upon the sunnah only for a short period of time. Wallahi, the affairs are indeed serious, because إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِخَوَاتِيمٍ. Actions are taken according to the end results. It may be that you do actions of the people of paradise in that which the people consider. that you're upon the people of paradise. And between you and paradise is an arm's length. And then what is written for you is written for you because you are not sincere. And you do actions from the people of the hellfire and you enter it. Nasallah salama. Innamal a'mal bi khawatim. That's why we all of us ask Allah for husnul khatima. Ask Allah for a good end. An end of sincerity. An end upon sincerity and upon the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because the reality is, none of us are guaranteed anything. The reality is, none of us are guaranteed paradise. None of us are guaranteed a good death. None of us are guaranteed that we die upon the sunnah. None of us are guaranteed that we die upon tawheed. So each and every one of us, every day becomes a striving day. Every day becomes a jihad against your soul. To make your soul upon tawheed and sunnah. To make your soul strive. Keep up the ibadat. Every day becomes a day of istighfar and tawbah and repentance. Because every day could be your last day. And that day could be where your soul comes out. Every day should be a day of dhikr. Every day should be a day of Quran. Every day should be a day of istighfar. Every day should be a day of tawbah. Every day should be a day of preparation for the akhirah. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqullaha wal tanzur nafsu ma qaddamat li ghadin wattaqullaha inna allaha khabirun bima ta'malun. Allah knows all that you do. So prepare for that day. The next day, the day which is coming. وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ نَسُوا اللَّهَ فَأَنْسَاهُمْ أَنْفُسَهُمْ. Don't be like those who forget Allah, for they made themselves forget themselves. Allah made them forget themselves. وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ نَسُوا اللَّهَ فَأَنْسَاهُمْ أَنْفُسَهُمْ. أُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ. They are the sinful ones. لَا يَسْتَوِي أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ وَأَصْحَابُ الْجَنَّةِ. أَصْحَابُ الْجَنَّةِ هُمُ الْفَائِزُونَ. They're not equal, the companions of the hellfire and the companions of paradise. The companions of paradise, they are the successful ones. Be from the successful ones. We seek the dunya, we want to be successful in the dunya. There's no harm in that which is halal, alhamdulillah. But be from the successful ones in the akhirah. فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازِ. The one who's saved from the punishment, زُحْزِحَ. And he enters paradise, then he's the one that is successful. So don't worship Allah upon an edge. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَا يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ عَلَى الْحَرْفِ. عَلَى الْحَرْفِ. They worship Allah upon an edge, يعني on the edge. Worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon yaqeen, upon istiqama. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا. Not only are they affirmed the rububi of Allah, but استسلموا لأمره. They fulfill his commandments because they submit to that. ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا عَلَى الصِّرَاطِ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ عِلْمًا وَعَمَلًا. With knowledge and action, Sheikh Sa'di says. فَلَهُمُ الْبُشْرَى فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. They will have glad tidings in this life and in the hereafter. تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ الْكِرَامِ أَيْ يَتَكَرَّرُ نُزُولُهُمْ. Not just one, two, they will be coming one after the other. Glad tidings for you. سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ طِبْتُمْ فَادْخُلُوهَا خَالِدِينَ. Your good soul, nafsu al-tayyiba, nafsu al-mutma'inna, salamun alaykum, mubashirin lahum inda al-ihtidar, upon the point of death, mubashirin, and la takhafu, don't be afraid, ala ma yastaqbilu min amrikum, in that which you're going to come, what's going to come to you, don't be afraid, because what you will have, inshallah, will have jannah, will have happiness, will have the pleasure of Allah, there isn't anything better than that. Seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the Day of Judgment. Seeing Allah for the believers. وُجُوهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ نَاظِرَةٌ إِلَى رَبِّهُمْ نَاظِرَةٌ. On that day faces will be brightened, illuminated, looking towards their Lord. And in paradise, as the people enter paradise, anything else that you will be given? Yes. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I have something for you that's extra, O people of paradise. يَا أَهْلَ الْجَنَّةِ. What is it that you will give us, Ya Allah? أَلَمْ تُبَيِّدْ وُجُوهَنَا. Didn't you brighten our faces? أَلَمْ تُدْخِلْنَا الْجَنَّةِ. Didn't you enter us into paradise? And it will be, and the veil will be removed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, نعم, will remove the veil and they will see their Lord. And there isn't anything better than that. وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا عَلَى مَا مَضَى. Don't be distressed about that which had already transpired in the past. You sought forgiveness for the past. You're making tawbah for the present,
whatever that you do, you're making tawbah. فَنَفَعْ عَنْهُمُ الْمَكْرُوهُ الْمَاضِي So the angels, they will give them the glad tidings of, don't be afraid. And don't, now ahead of you is the mustaqbal. Ahead of you is glad tidings for the future because of what you used to do. And it will be said to them, أُدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةَ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ Enter paradise of what you used to do. It's about actions, Ya Abdullah. It's about amal. And that amal must be salih upon ilm. Upon ikhlas. وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوْعَدُونَ فَإِنَّهَا قَدْ وَجَدْتُمْ فَإِنَّهَا قَدْ وَجَدْتَ لَكُمْ أَوْ وُجِدَتْ لَكُمْ وَثَبَتَتْ It is provided for you. Just like this dunya was provided for each and every one of us to walk. Paradise will be provided for you, Ya Abdullah. For the person who is upon ikhlas and sunnah. وَكَانَ وَعْدُ اللَّهِ مَفْعُولًا And the promise of Allah is going to happen. The promise of Allah, كَانَ مَفْعُولًا It's going to happen. And it will be said to them also, مُثْبِتِينَ لَهُمْ وَمُبَشِّرِينَ نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاءَكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ يَحُثُّونَهُمْ فِي الدُّنْيَا عَلَى الْخَيْرِ The angels will be calling you to good in this life. Ya Abdullah, don't you read Quran? Ya Abdullah, isn't that which you did that was wrong? Ya Abdullah, shouldn't you make tawbah? Ya Abdullah, seek forgiveness from Allah. Ya Abdullah, establish your prayer. Ya Abdullah, pray on time. Ya Abdullah, don't miss your witr. Ya Abdullah, do good. Do be righteous to your parents. Ya Abdullah, be good to your neighbors. Ya Abdullah, bring about khair. Ya Abdullah, has this day been beneficial? Ya Abdullah, is this a day for you or against you? Ya Abdullah, angels, يحثونهم في الدنيا على الخير. Sheikh Sa'di rahmullah says, ويزينونهم لهم. And they will beautify the khair to them. As opposed to the devils, the shayateen. And the qareen that is with you and me. Each one has a qareen. Calling us to the nar. Calling us to the hellfire. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about shaitan, what he will say. Then I will lead them all astray. إِلَّا عِبَادَكَ مِنْهُمُ الْمُخْلَصِينَ لَأَغْوِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ I will lead them all astray. إِلَّا عِبَادَكَ مِنْهُمُ الْمُخْلَصِينَ Except the sincere ones amongst them. And he will call you to miss your prayers. And he will call you to be from Ashab al-Jahim. And he will call you to leave Tawheed and be upon Shirk, first and foremost. And he will call you to Bid'ah. And he will call you to beautify your sins. And he will call you to follow your desires. But the person who feared his desires and وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ And he feared that place of meeting with Allah. وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى Then paradise will be his abode. فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى But the one who followed his desires, نسأل الله السلامة, took his desires as his deity. They're the ones who will be followers of the devils, of shayateen, of the shayateen. Then Shaykh Sa'di rahimahullah said, the angels will be calling them to that which is good in this dunya, of khair. وَيَرْهَبُونَهُمْ عَنِ الشَّرْ And they warn them of evil. نَعَمْ وَيَقْبَحُونَهُ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ أَوْ يُقَبِّحُونَهُ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ And they make it detestable in their hearts. They say, this is not good, this is not good for you, Ya Abdullah, this is not good for your akhirah. وَيَدْعُونَ اللَّهَ لَهُمْ And they supplicate. They supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect these worshippers in this life. When you're there waiting for the prayer, اللَّهُمَّ اغْفِرْ لَهُ وَارْحَمُهُ اللَّهُمَّ اغْفِرْ لَهُ وَارْحَمُهُ اللَّهُمَّ اغْفِرْ لَهُ وَارْحَمُهُ Supplicating for you. The حَمَلَةُ الْعَرْشِ Supplicating for you and your family. And likewise the angels supplicating for you. وَيُثَبِّتُونَهُمْ عِنْدَ الْمَصَائِبِ والمخاوف and also they make them firm upon the time of difficulty. Like this time of difficulty people are going through. Where the people are afraid of something they can't even see. The coronavirus. They can't even see it. And they are afraid. And first and foremost they must be afraid of Allah. The one that they can't see as well. But He is the one. Everything eludes that He is the creator. Everything that you see around you. That it has a creator. Everything that you see.
around you, بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ يَدُلُّ عَلَى أَنَّهُ وَاحِدٌ, and it proves that Allah is الْوَاحِدُ الْقَهَّارُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. All of it, all of the creation, that which you see and that which you do not see, that which you haven't even seen, all of it eludes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of all of it. All of it following a command, the sun rising in the east and setting in the west, the moon that makes the light trajected from it to you and me in the nights, especially in the middle of the month when we see the moon in its splendor, in its full splendor. The Ayyam al-Bid, 13, 14, 15th of the lunar month, and the moon is in its full splendor, and that's every month for you and me, Ya Abdullah. Provisions that he provides for you and me, Ya Abdullah, shelter, sustenance, all of that is proof that he is the creator of the heavens and the earth, and the greatest miracle that is given to us, the Quran. If one were just to read the Quran, no doubt that would be sufficient for them. If they were to read the Quran with sincerity, they would recognize who they are in relation to their creator and their maker, that they are in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the angels call you to good in this life and call you away from the evils and make it detestable in your eyes, whilst the devils, they try to beautify the haram in your eyes. The angels supplicate for you, Ya Abdullah. They try and make you firm by supplicating for you. يثبتونهم عند المصائب والمخاوف وخصوصا عند الموت وشدته, and upon death especially and its agonies. The angels, Ya Abdullah, that we believe in, that are created from light, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed them for the believers to aid them in supplicating for them. So at the point of death for the believers, لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. And then, as your soul is taken, the angels are commanded to take your soul, and it rises up, and the heavens are opened, and you are addressed with the most beautiful of names. And for the disbelievers, they are addressed with the most evil of names, and their soul is thrown back into their bodies. That's Allah salama. And for the believers, no. For the believers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands the angels to take care of your soul. To take care of your soul, and it is put back into your body once you enter the grave. And you are asked by those two angels, Munkar al-Nakir, Man Rabbuk, Ma Deenuk, Man Hada al-Rajul Ladhi Bu'itha Ilaykum, who is your Lord and what is your Deen, and who is the person that was sent to you as a messenger. And you're there on your own in the darkness, and above you is soil, a meter or two of soil, and you're on your own, and you hear the footsteps of those who came to visit your grave to bury you, and they leave, and you're there now, you and your actions. يَتْبَعُ الْمَيْتْ ثَلَاثْ وَيَرْجَعْ إِثْنَانْ وَيَبْقَى وَاحِدْ يَرْجَعْ أَهْلُهُ وَمَالُهُ, his wealth and his family leave, and what is left for you? وَيَبْقَى عَمَلُهُ, what is left for the person in the grave is his actions. And in Yawm al-Qiyamah, and its difficulty and its hardship, the sirat that each and every one of us must go over, the bridge which is sharper than a sword and finer than a hair. And there are hooks, kalalib, over it. And people will be caught by these hooks and thrown into the fire because the sirat is over the hellfire. And the anbiya, as they see that, or as they see the situation, how serious it is, they'll be saying, Allahumma sallim, sallim. Oh Allah, protect, protect. Everyone is in need of Allah. The anbiya calling for Allah's salvation. Oh Allah, protect, protect. So how can you call upon others besides Allah in this life and in the hereafter? In this life, why are people calling upon the dead then? Oh Sufis. Why are you calling upon the dead? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَوْ سَمِعُوا مَا اسْتَجَابُوا لَكُمْ, even if they were to hear you, they will not be able to help you. They will not be able to answer you. Everyone has to worship Allah and call upon Allah alone, not call upon the dead. For all of that belongs to Allah. All might and all power belongs to Allah. Don't we say, لَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ? So how is it now we're saying La Hawla belongs to Abdul Qadir al-Jilani? لا حول إلا لعبد القادر. Why are we saying that? It's as if we're saying that. That the might and power belongs to other than Allah. أعوذ بالله. And we know, we say, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. It doesn't belong to Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم, who himself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded him to say, ألا له الخلق والأمر. That to Allah belongs the creation and the command. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to say to himself, لَيْسَ لَكَ مِنَ الْأَمْرِ شَيْءٍ. The affair does not belong to you. The affair belongs to Allah. You are a messenger of Allah, and Allah raised you to be the best of the messengers and the best of the creation. But the affair does not belong to you. So the believers who will be getting and rejoicing with their book in the right hand and will go over the sirat very swiftly as they get to the gates of paradise, the angels saying to them, Salamun alaykum, welcoming them to enter paradise. And the first of them to be entering paradise is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Only him, first and foremost, will be first opened. No one else before him will be opened for, except Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And as for the disbelievers and the hypocrites, as they enter the hellfire, the angels will say, the gatekeepers of the hellfire will say, أَلَمْ يَأْتِكُمْ نَذِيرٌ. Didn't no warner come to you? بَلَا قَدْ جَاءَنَا نَذِيرٌ فَكَذَّبْنَاهُ وَقُلْنَا مَا نَزَّلَ اللَّهُ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. As they enter the, they will say, yes, a warner came to us, but we denied them, we belied them. And we said, Allah didn't receive anything. Allah didn't reveal anything. As they enter, they will be punished in the hellfire. And it will be said to them, فَدْعُ نَادِيَ. Call upon those who you used to call upon in this life besides Allah. Call up, do the shirk that you used to do now. Can you do the shirk now? أَدْعُ نَادِيَ. If you do that, your helpers, you try and call your help, no one's going to help you. Allah replied to them, سَنَدْعُ الزَّبَانِيَ. We will call upon our angels that will punish you in the hellfire. You will call upon those trying to help you in the, that you used to call upon besides Allah. سَنَدْعُ الزَّبَانِيَ. Look how powerful that verse is. فَلْيَدْعُ نَادِيَ. سَنَدْعُ الزَّبَانِيَ. The Zabaniya will punish the people in the hellfire. And they will call upon Malik. Ya Malik, لِيَقْضِيَ عَلَيْنَا رَبُّكُ. Oh Malik, make your Lord destroy us. They don't want to be punished anymore. Make your Lord destroy us. It will be said to them, إِنَّكُمْ مَاكِثُونَ. You will remain there and reside there forever. As disbelievers who committed shirk, you will be there forever. No water to drink, except, and no food except ghislin. No water except pus that comes out of the zani and the zaniyat's private parts. نسأل الله السلامة. And ghislin, that food that they will eat. نسأل الله السلامة. May Allah protect us from that shajarat al-zakkum. Ta'amun athim. An evil food that will burn their insides and pus scalded their heads. And zakkum, the tree, ru'us, the fruits of the branches, like ru'us shayateen, like the heads of devils. That will be their food. And it will neither nourish them nor bring them any sustenance. That's the situation in the hellfire. They will call upon the people of paradise. Give us that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided you. But Allah, they will reply to them, in Allah harramaha alaykum. Allah made it forbidden for you. That is the reality of the akhirah, Ya Abdullah. That is the reality of the akhirah that is coming. يَرَوْنَهَا بَعِيدًا وَنَرَاهُ قَرِيبًا وَنَرَاهَا قَرِيبًا. They see it as far away and we see it as close. It's happening. And it's coming close. Just yesterday you were this age and you were that age and you grew and now you are elderly. It's happening. You can't stop time. You can't stop yourself from growing and going back to becoming like a baby, weak and in need of Allah. It's happening and it's coming. Ya ayyuhal insan, innaka kadihun ila rabbika kadhan famulaqi. You're going to meet him. Of a surety. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us and aid us and forgive us our shortcomings. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those who always on a daily, on a day-to-day basis, daily, prepare for this akhirah. Prepare for our meeting. Don't make it too late. Don't make it too late, because time is passing very quickly. Start now. And start by continuing that which the Messenger called you to, with the adhkar in the morning and the evening, with pondering over the Quran. Start with keeping up your prayers. Start with saying a good word or keeping silence. Start with withholding your hands from harming others. Start with eating that which is halal. Start with eating or benefiting from that which is, which will bring about good. And before all that, keep away from shirk. Know the different types of shirk that will land you in the hellfire forever. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Know the evils of bid'ah and innovations. Know the evils of disobedience to Allah, and sins are destructive. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you call upon Him and you are pious, He will teach you. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهِ. Ask Allah in your sujood sincerely for guidance. Allah will give you guidance. وَسُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمْ وَبِحَمْدِكَ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْكَ.